this is the hydraulic clutch, and those are the components. This is the torque converter. The torque converter is located inside of the bell housing because it's where the clutch is located. And after that, we have in this area the oil pump. The oil pump, that's the element that circulates the oil internally, enter into the torque converter. You remember, 3/4 of oil on the torque converter and return into the transmission. And after that, we have a set of planetary gears and clutch packs. And today we are going to understand the meaning of the planetary gears and how the planetary gears multiply the torque and multiply the RPMs or reduce the RPMs, how the speeds are produced on the planetary gears. Okay, as we explained before, the main difference between the manual transmission and the automatic transmission, there are a lot of difference, but the main difference is on the clutch. In the manual transmission, the clutch is a dry clutch, it's a mechanical clutch. Be careful because the people confuse. I have mechanical clutch with hydraulic clutch thrust bearing, but the clutch is mechanical. Remember that we have three types of thrust bearings in the mechanical clutch. Mechanical clutch with the fork, hydraulic with the hydraulic fluid, and electrical like a solenoid. But this is a mechanical clutch or dry clutch. In the moment that you remove the torque converter, you need to be careful with the oil because this torque converter is full of fluid. If you check over there, we have a lot of fluid coming out through the torque converter. Okay, and right now we are in front of the oil pump. This is the oil pump. We are going to remove those four bolts and we are going to remove the oil pump. The oil pump have a bigger O-ring over there. So this is a perfect schematic of the automatic transmission. We have here the torque converter, and after that we have the oil pump, and after that the set of planetary gears and the clutch packs, and in the bottom we have the valve body, and we have the computer and the filter and the fluid return, because the oil pump suction the fluid again and return and return and return. This is basically the schematic of the automatic transmission. This picture, the second picture, this is another good schematic about the automatic transmission. Let me show what happened in this particular transmission. This is the torque converter, and the fluid is located in the bottom, and this is the oil pump. The oil pump suction the fluid and the fluid enter. You remember the fluid because the stator introduced the fluid over there. The fluid passed in front of the turbine. Exactly, the fluid passed in front of the turbine and moved the turbine against the face of the torque converter and engaged the clutch. And the fluid after that return over there, and the fluid enter. This is the set of planetary gears. Those are the clutch packs, and those are the servo valves. And one portion of the fluid goes in, normally in automotive transmissions, goes into the radiator, and in the radiator the oil is cooled and returned with low temperature into the transmission. In this particular case, I have 25 in the first one, 75 in the big one. The gear ratio is 3:1, and the middle one no affect idle gear, no affect the gear ratio. Right now, both of them are rotating in the same direction. Both of them are clockwise. Wonderful. You remember that idle gear was introduced when you select reverse in the previous transmission, the manual transmission. Yes, if I wanted to change the sense of rotation of the second gear, I introduced the idle gear. That's the function of the idle gear. And in this particular example, all the gears are externals. But I can connect the same configuration internal, like this. I have the input gear and the output gear, one inside of the other one, no externals. not like this. What is the advantage of the second of this option? Oh, in this option, I have all the shafts aligned. Ah, if one shaft is hollow and enter in the other one, and the other shaft is bigger and is hollow and enter, I have all the shafts one inside of the other one, like a telescopic. This is the perfect situation. We have the yellow shaft inside of the blue one, and all of them are hollow. The yellow one, the fluid in the yellow one can pass internally through this point. With respect to the last one, to the green one, we can install the shaft. We can design the shaft for the green one here, connected to the triangle, to the link. And this shaft, of course, will be hollow. In this particular case, we have three shafts completely aligned. Or you can put all of those three shafts, one inside of the other one. The planetary gear is a set of gears, the sun, the planets, and the ring. Those elements can be combined together in this array. The sun, the planets are connected together, and the ring. Each set of planetary gears produce two gear ratios under drive in forward, and two gear ratios overdrive in forward. Each couple of gear ratios, underdrive or overdrive, one is useful and the other one unuseful. For that reason, in a typical automatic transmission, you have one set. Suppose that the transmission is four speed in forwards. I have one planetary gears for two gear ratios, and other one in tandem for the other two gear ratios. That transmission internally have two sets of planetary gears, because it's four speeds in forward. And in one of those is produced the reverse. And right now, I am going to explain how is the process to produce first gear, second gear. This is the shaft with the clutch pack for forward. This is the input shaft. In this moment, the input shaft, and this is the gear that engage with the gear of the output shaft with the coupling. That gear engage with this gear. In this moment, because fluid is not entering here, the input shaft is not engaged with the output shaft. The output shaft in this moment is stationary, because I don't have pressure of fluid at the input. I don't have fluid entering at high pressure over there. When the fluid enter here, because this one is selected in forward, the body of valves, the fluid enter here, pass over there, and immediately enter in the clutch pack. In the clutch pack, I have a set of friction discs with stainless steel, separated. I have friction plate, stainless steel plate, friction plate, stainless steel plate. I have like at 15 and 15 or 20 and 20, depending of the clutch pack. Those elements are located internally here. If you check those plates, the friction plates have the teeth internal, and the stainless steel plates, they have those teeth externals. In other words, I have one shaft connected internally with the friction discs, and I have other case connected externally with the stainless steel plates. This is the set of planetary gears. And this set, the ring, The ring is here. This is the ring. I enter here into the ring. And the procedure to stop the ring, this element, is with the servo band. The servo band have friction material here, the same friction material used in the clutch pack. You remember in the clutch pack, you have friction material, friction discs with the teeth internals, and stainless steel, friction material, stainless steel, friction material, stainless steel. Ah, in other words, the clutch pack, one shaft is connected with the internal teeth of the friction material, and other shaft is connected with the teeth of the stainless steel plates. When the fluid enters at high pressure over there, compress the plates, and this shaft is engaged with this. This is the clutch pack, you remember, in the previous example. The servo band is the same friction material with a stainless steel band. And this element is externally on the ring. It's located externally on the ring. And this element is activated with a solenoid. Okay, in this particular example, I have this situation. This is the input shaft. This is the input shaft, and this is the output shaft, the yellow one. Let me analyze. The input shaft, according with our previous explanation, is the ring. Okay, this is the ring, yes, okay. Yes, this is the ring. That's clear, that's the ring. The output shaft is the carrier of the planets. Okay, the output shaft is the green, that one. This is the output shaft. Okay, the output shaft, the green, is connected with this planet, and is connected with this planet. Okay, all right. The green is the carrier of the planets, and is the output shaft here. Let me analyze that situation. Is this, once again, the input is on the ring, the input is on the ring. For that reason, I put here on the ring 7 RPMs. And the sun is stopped, is zero. And we are going to analyze what happened with the planets, the carrier. This is the output shaft. Nice. This is the situation. This is the situation that we have. The sun is locked, is stopped, is not moving. If you check the sun here, the red one, is not moving. And the output shaft are the planets. The output shaft is spinning slower than the ring. This is first gear. And what is the gear ratio?